Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's look at using vintage photo effects in iPhoto. So it's very popular now to post photos online and apply filters to make them look like old vintage photographs. And the effect can really make a photo come to life. You can do this using lots of apps, of course the most popular being Instagram. But if you have photos in your iPhoto collection on your Mac, you can also apply filters in there and get similar effects. Let's take a look. So first, of course, select a photo in iPhoto and get the original there. Of course, it should have crisp, clear color because it's taken with a modern camera. And now we want to make it look old. So what you want to do is go down to the bottom to the Edit button. Once you're in Edit mode, you have a variety of options here, including Quick Fixes. And this will make the picture look even better usually. So you don't want that. You want to instead go to Effects. Now under Effects we have a variety of different things, some of which right away show us that we can make things look old. For instance, we can click on the Antique button here and we get an effect right away that is pretty decent. If you ever want to undo an effect, you can simply hit the Undo button here at the bottom. Also notice when I click on it once I get a 1 at the bottom there, and I click on it again, go 2, 3, 4, and you see the effect gets more pronounced. I can also use the arrows here at the bottom to go back and forth, so I can go up numbers and down numbers to get kind of the amount of the effect that I want. You can also combine effects. So for instance, I can click here to go 1 with antique, and I can add a vignette effect there as well. So I can have a combination of the two of them, and I can increase each one separately and see what the combination is. Now you also have these color control buttons here at the top. So if something is very bright and crisp, you can darken it. And when you click on these, what you need to do is basically just click on them several times and you can see the effect get darker. You can always click undo to go back one step, or you can always click revert to original to erase all of the changes that you've made here. So now it's a matter of coming up with the perfect effect, and it's really kind of a subjective thing. You can try adding a few different things. Antique here, I'll do that 1, and I'll do an edge blur. And I'll do that maybe up to 4 or 5. That's a little too much there. Let's go down to about 3, 2. So I get a little bit of blur around the edges to make it look like it was an old camera. Maybe the lens wasn't perfect. And then I can play around with the rest to get the effect I want. A little boost there. Kind of makes the photo look a little more washed out. And I can try some things and then turn it off if I don't like it. And once I have what I want, I can then basically I'm done. The changes are saved automatically. I can go back to the photo here. I can turn off the effects and go back, and I can see now when I go back into the photo it has those changes I've made. I could always go back into Edit whenever I want and hit revert to original. It will give me a warning this time since I've edited it and then left and then come back in. And I can revert and get back to my original. iPhoto saves the original as well as the modifications. If you want finer control, you can always go into Adjust instead of Effects, and in here you can really go to town and fine tune the effects here in Changes. So there's a lot you can do here, and this is for a more expert level. Changing the temperature is really something that can work to change the look of a photo, and tinting it as well. Now what I like to do is I would set it for antique of 1, an edge blur of 2, and then also add a fade and a boost. And for me that creates the kind of effect that I remember older photographs having after they sit around in an album for a while and are taken with a camera say from the 70s. So what you like may vary. So play around with these, maybe find your favorite set of settings. Of course I may depend upon the photo itself, and post your favorite set to this episode at MacMost.com. And the great thing about using iPhoto now in Mountain Lion is once you've created your effect you can hit the share button, and right from there you can share to Facebook, Flickr, Twitter, and of course you can create shared photo streams as well. So it's easy to share your photos once you've created the modification. What I really like about doing this in iPhoto instead of in an app is I don't have to decide at the time I take the photo what effect I want to use or whether I want to use an effect at all. I can just concentrate on getting good photos, taking lots of them, and then later on go into iPhoto on my Mac and make these modifications. And then I have the original in iPhoto as well as the modification. And of course in a lot of the apps you can do that as well. It'll save the original as well as the changed version. But it's easier sometimes just focus on the photography and worry about these filters later on. Hope you found this useful. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. Want more video tutorials? Just go to MacMost.com, click on the videos link at the top of the page, and then you can view all of the hundreds of MacMost videos by category.